I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places.
Hello, so today we're going to be doing my Christmas gift haul, and this is everything but the gift cards because who wants to sit through that? But first I would like to point out this lovely midnight sequence top, which has shoulder padding. This I inherited from my grandmother, which she wore this in the 1980s on her Mexican cruise, I guess, or that's so I've been told. And then also this Lele Sedohi luxury headband, I'll call it. It has, well, it's like a black velvet, and it has these tiny, I don't know if you can see it, but these gold sequences. Yeah, they're super tiny, but kind of ruffled. It's like this black velvet material. But anyways, I have their business card. This is something that came in a subscription box, and my aunt ended up giving it to me. But basically, or it's probably blurry, but basically, this brand is just frivolity. These are some very outlandish headbands. Maybe not this one. I mean, this one was pretty, this was one of their cheapest, I think. So my aunt didn't pay retail, or it was included in this. There were other things in the subscription box. I don't know which one it was. But basically, if we looked at the retail of this, we would be paying $68 for this headband, which is crazy. But you'd be shocked that some of these other headbands that I don't even think are like real gemstones, they may be semi-precious, but it's like these are just rhinestones and the other things on here that they sew on, and it's like some of these headbands can go up to like $200. It's like crazy. Like, I would never buy that. And they're really kind of bulky, but maybe not this one, but I'm thinking of this. Now, I know that is sometimes like a, that's a style thing, but it's very Norma Desmond, but taken at another extreme level. So I guess I would consider this headband part of the Christmas gifts too. But I mean, it's comfy, I like it, but oh my god, the retail. So I guess I'll start off with these gifts from my aunt and uncle. So first I have this, it's like a Rice Krispie. It's a hot cocoa peppermint Rice Krispie treat. It's like in this huge square. It has marshmallows on top and crushed peppermint. So there's that. And then from the same subscription box as the Lele Sedohi headband, my aunt got me this Laura Galaire The Social Butterfly all-in-one face palette. So it comes with everything that you need for your eyeshadow, and then highlighter and blush. So here's the actual palette. It's fairly like medium sized. This would be super good for when you're traveling, because it's like all in one. It's all right there. You don't need to take a separate container of this or that. And it comes with a mirror. Yes, I tied red ribbons on my music stand. There they are. So, yeah, but a lot of these palettes nowadays, I think they always come with a mirror on the bottom, on the other side of the lid. So, I don't really want to take off the plastic since I probably wouldn't use it right away. But you can kind of see the different components here. Then I got this sleeping mask. Usually I don't ever use sleeping masks because I don't need to. I have the curtains, but I guess if you were like traveling or you were at some awkward angle, but kind of like this because it's like simple but like not too boring because you have little eyelashes peeking through, I guess. So yeah, I'll have to try that, I guess, whenever I feel the need. And then I got these sheet masks, like two for each. This one is a vitamin C essence. And then this is a hyaluronic acid one. So this one is energizing and awakening, and this is reviving and super hydrating. Then this is the story to it. So my aunt got this smoked old fashioned body wash by Bath and Body Works for my uncle, and my uncle tried it once and it wasn't bad, but he said like soon after it was way too much of the smokiness, and he said it was an overkill scent, as I would put it, but something along the lines of that, I don't remember. But I have the body spray of this in my other room, so I don't really have the notes, but so they kind of like regifted this to me, and I knew this, so I chuckled as I like opened the box full of packing peanuts, and it's this one bottle in there. But I guess now I lovingly like joke that if they made a body wash based on Columbo, it would probably smell like this. Kind of, maybe this is a little fancy for him, but the cigar smoke, I mean, yeah, if you smell this, you'll get it. I hope, but, regift, but I do love the scent, just because it, well, now it reminds me of Columbo. Because I made it that way, but I like it. I do like that smokiness, so yeah. I don't have a problem with it. And then I got this stress relief eucalyptus and spearmint bubble bath. This is also by My Beauty Spot, under the aromatherapy line. Those are just the directions, but I got this hangover wash the day away. By Too Faced. It's like it's a foaming cleanser, you know, the detoxifying, purifying, whatever type thing. Probably something like after you take your makeup off, and it also removes makeup. So, it says it right somewhere here. It's pretty blurry, but yeah, there's a lot of information on here. This is a full size. I had asked my aunt to get this for me on Ulta. It was on clearance, so yeah. I don't know, I thought I would try it out. I'm gonna do a shout out for this wrapping paper segment that I picked out. Especially just to get a chuckle at. It says to Jasmine from crossed out Satan Santa. That was the first time my uncle did this, so I want him to do it like to all the presents, because apparently I am the Jasmine and Satan wanted to give me gifts. So there you go. And then my aunt picked out for me this Cary Grant, kind of like an overview book of his life. And, well, more than anything, just like all the movie stills and like the publicity photos he was in. I wouldn't say... it's not a biography, but it's just it's more so like, yeah, all the movies he's been in. This is North by Northwest. I love that movie. And there's, I don't know the show, but they have the movie poster. I could go through this all day. Like this. So, yeah. And I like the back because this gets me every time. The other, like, I don't know, it's probably in here, but the other photo that I know so well of him in, like, in a bathrobe, like, just lounging around the house, is that fluffy one from Bringing Up Baby. That's probably in here. And they also picked out for me these... statement clip-on earrings. These are teardrop AB crystal, and I think AB crystal is like my favorite over regular just white rhinestone or white diamonds or something, you know, clear. Whereas like this, I don't know, I just like this having all the iridescence in it. And, I don't know what I did with the, packaging for this, but these are the other pair of clip-on earrings, so they're kind of curved, which is cool. And, yeah, so, it's like, these are, regular rhinestones. They are AB crystal stones too. Yeah. Okay. I had to look those closely. But yeah. So I really like these clip-ons. You know, they're just easy to throw on, so it's like I have pierced ears, I guess, but I'm a vintage soul con, like I gotta have my clip-ons too, so yeah. That's why I have them, and I kind of like took interest in them. So these are from Pure Vida. These are both pierced earrings. All of these are like rose gold, but with a brass base. So rose gold plating and crystal stone and sterling silver posts. For these, and then this has a cubic zirconia and glass pearl as well. Glass pearls. So they're kind of small, but I like the danglies. So you can see that clearly. But and three ear cuffs, too. Then she gave me this rose water hydrator spray from the brand Frownies. I don't know if this was like a subscription box, but knowing that she didn't care for rose scented stuff as much, she gave it to me. So it's still sealed, but I'll have to try this someday, but another bonus. It's like these random things here and there. I don't really know how to like put it, but now this it's from when I went back to Michigan, my aunt and uncle, my aunt is from Michigan, hence my mom's family's, you know, they're all Michiganers. So, this is, I'll call it a book pocket. It's like a faux leather and it has the cute cats on it. It's a book pocket or like a book pouch, and it has this snap seal. It's fabric lined, and basically when you're traveling or really anywhere, you're out and about, you can, assuming your book would fit here, you can slide your book in to this pouch and it will protect it from potential rain or, I don't know, sun damage. It'll just a nice protective case for your book, I guess. I thought that would be fun. And we have this emery board. It's a purple Eiffel Tower with a purple tassel. And this is gonna be for display. I'm not using this thing because it's very, very frivolous. I mean, look at this. Yeah. I mean, you could use this as an emery board, but, it is a nail filer, but also, I don't know. This seems like, I don't know what else to say. But she thought I would like it. And I do. I like it. You know, it's a nice purple shade. And Eiffel Tower and France, because they're still like, oh, you took French and whatnot. Okay, it's all for the Michigan stuff. So this is from, they call it Mad Monster Conventions, or Mad Monster. It's like this convention, not like Comic-Con, I mean, I don't know, but it's like an event that my aunt and uncle go there, so they brought back some of this treasure from the vendors over there. So this is like a loose tea leaf strainer, and I could get these anywhere, but also I guess I was like, yes, I want this just because it has this cute little charm at the end of the Cheshire Cat. So yeah. There's this neat latch where I can put my loose tea, and I don't typically use loose tea, but that's also why she picked this out for me, I believe from the same vendor. It's called Descend into Madness. I like how they have the imagery and then the little description on the back. Come down the rabbit hole with this herbal lucid dreaming tea made with organic blue lotus flower, mugwort, spearmint, ginkgo leaf, passion fruit, and orange peel. Some fancy handmade tea. So yeah, these go hand in hand. And then also from Mad Monster, my aunt and uncle got a bunch of movie posters and photo stills from some Twilight Zone episodes. So I'm gonna start off with Hitchcock's Vertigo. And and I'm gonna have to find frames for all of these. But I love the movie poster, and this is very hard to say, but I think this is my favorite Hitchcock movie. Because, you know, like, looking back, there's so many that I could say are my top favorite, and they all just want to be number one, but it's Vertigo. Yeah, there's something about that story that gets me every time. Then I have Strangers on a Train. I think this is my, again, it's hard to decide these things, but this is my second favorite Hitchcock film. And I am biased because of the actors I love so much. I mean, for Vertigo, like, I'm a big James Stewart fan. I don't know about Kim Novak as much. Like, I don't know if I really had much an opinion on her. I liked her character. I liked how she looked in the film. But, like, big names to me is, like, James Stewart. And usually it's the actors. This one, I do like Fairley Granger. He was a good leading role, but it's, Robert Walker that I seek out so much in this movie. Like, whenever I watch this, I always pay attention to him, like, 100%. Like, I love that actor, and it's so sad how his life got cut so short. But it's, you know, like, it's like kind of like the legend lives on within this movie and other things. But also, I think this, like, I know he was in so many other movies that I have to see, and I have like a list going, but this one was like one of his most memorable roles, and I think that's just a great thing. Unfortunately, I do feel like Strangers on a Train is kind of underrated, like a hidden gem, and that's rare being a Hitchcock movie, because everybody knows Hitchcock, and for him to have an underrated movie is just devastating. Like, I don't know, I feel like everybody should know this movie, but don't. But yeah. Here's the Twilight Zone posters. Yeah. With Rod Serling. I probably need more wall space too, but, well, when I move, it's gonna be in a few years, but when I move, I'll have that wall space, but for now, I'm gonna, like, keep all of these safe in my, secretary drawer. But, I mean, I'm hoping to get some frames soon. It's like, there's way too many things I want to display, and I can't, because there's no wall room, and it's just, like, it's too much. But, like, I like this stuff. And, like, sometimes, like, I'll see those walls where every inch is covered in picture frames. It's like, why can't I be like that? I would just love my room to be a living Pinterest board. And my last photo still is from the Twilight Zone, Eye of the Beholder. This is my top favorite Twilight Zone episode. And, like, I have a list of all my favorites. It was really hard deciding, but it's this one. It's just the irony, and it just made me realize we as humans kind of just set up what defines as beauty standards, and it's like, yeah, I mean, it is something created by humans. It's not like it's always there, and looking at this alternate universe that the Twilight Zone gives us makes us realize that what we believe is not what, you know, another society or another culture believes in. You know, even though we think it's so universally understood, and, well, I'm talking about alternate universes, I guess, just because Twilight Zone is sci-fi, but like 100% real life, but you can just see, like, the little hints here and there. There are, like, real life things in here, but then it takes that sci-fi or supernatural turn when you go into the Twilight Zone. And so I guess growing up, I never watched the Twilight Zone. I didn't watch any, like, old TV shows like this. I watched a lot of Boomerang. I was a Hanna-Barbera kid, but also, like, even not until recently was I watching Twilight Zone or Perry Mason or Hogan's Heroes or Columbo or Murder, She Wrote, even. Despite my mom and aunt, or at least one or the other, like, having their own TV shows, and from the list I gave, that was basically what I came up with. And that's how I mostly found out about those shows, because of them. But then you see that's years later. But, maybe I wasn't ready to grasp that at such a young age, or this or that. But I have a lot of favorite Twilight Zone episodes. I love Nothing in the Dark because Robert Redford is so fine. And they're, I don't know if Robert Redford is in other episodes, but I hope he should be because he's just so great in there. I like the After Hours. There's something about that. I don't know, they take the simplest things and they make it so surreal, inside the department store. I just love that. And it gets real weird with the mannequins. And I love Time Enough at Last because I love Burgess Meredith and reading in the books. And that's the whole irony thing too. There's so much, I love the irony, and there's so much I don't know, it's great how they tie in irony and sci-fi and supernatural. And they just put it all together. The Invaders, or Stop at Willoughby. I have a lot of favorites, but I think Eye of the Beholder is the one that hits really hard. My grandma Eileen from Hawaii gave me, got me this set, this jewelry set, with a matching necklace and matching earrings. There's sterling silver. So I think this is from Macy's, but and then I don't want these to fall out, but it's the same design. But well, you know what's interesting is that the stones in the jewelry is an opal. It's not even a regular rhinestone cut, but it's not rhinestone, it's opal. It's this milky stone, which is different. And then from my Aunt Yumiko and Uncle Laren in Hawaii, got me a hydro flask, and I've never had a hydro flask, actually. Just had kind of lesser known brand drinking vessels. So I like the insulated. That is a recurring theme for me. I love that. And I think this is a pretty decent size. There's some huge ones. I wouldn't want a huge one. I don't know if, I don't know if I would want to put stickers on this just yet, because I'm saving stickers for my car, and it's hard for me to choose which ones I'm ready to let go in case they get ruined or something. But I have a nice canvas here to put stickers. I guess if I happen to, I love my vinyl stickers. I don't want to let them go, even though they're still going to be on here anyways. But this is new because it's smooth. I have a textured drinking vessel, and it's so different. But I love the lilac color, and it is a wide mouth. But I don't really use a nozzle or anything. So this is a gift that my friend Jayla from school got me. I love the purple gift bag and the purple tissue paper. And she knows that I love purple, so I figured. And this is a gift card box. But I just wanted to show like the design. They're dinosaurs. That's so cute. But yeah, I think I don't know about the other stuff, but this box I know is from Dollar Tree. She has a really cool Dollar Tree where everything they carry, my Dollar Tree doesn't carry. So it's, you know, it's cool to find like different things despite them being the same store and in the same area. So I'm assuming she made these. So she's a jewelry maker and she does have her own brand where she sells handmade jewelry. It's really cool. But yeah, I love the black and white style and the crackle beads, kind of like a marbly, they're not marble, what is it? Granite. It's close, something about granite. But I love that she remembered that I can only wear like post or stud earrings because of the re-piercing of my ears and the scar tissue. So yeah, I love this. Interesting fuzzy socks, but they have like the tin foil for the fuzz. So all of these gifts are from Leah, the mod maid. And this is all from Michigan, maybe parts of Canada, because they share that border. But she actually was able to send this bag to me too. This is where she got some of the items that I'll point out. It's the store called Mary Maxim. And half of the store, apparently they sell yarn here, as seen in the photo. So they sell some arts and crafts, but, or like crafting items, but then also like the other half of the store are, I dare say, gag gifts, because I didn't really understand it well at first when she was trying to describe it. It's weird put it, but probably like bits and bobbles and like odd things, like odd gifts, or like Dollar Tree has weird things, but that's only because, you know, they can sell them at a really cheap price and just have all these little things floating around in the store. But apparently this Mary Maxim was quite expensive for this stuff. Or not expensive, but like kind of pricey, and I was like, oh, really? But yeah. And there's one item, I think it's, one item might be from Five Below, but it's all in all, like, yeah, I'm not gonna say or differentiate, but this was from like a regular store. These Rito like assorted mints for, like, I want to say dinner mints, but they just assorted mints. I don't think they're like a butter mint though. I've never seen this brand before, but yeah, I'm assuming they're just like these nice little palette cleansers. I know this wasn't from Mary Maxim. So it's a, I think this was like in a $5 section. I don't know if it was Five Below. I've never seen this anything like this. It's a mini travel kit. You get a sleeping mask, a scrunchie, this suitcase, and then a mini phone stand. Yeah, so it's like a suitcase case. Yeah, and there's the wheels to it. And then you open this latch. This is all plastic, by the way. And then all this stuff is like neatly folded into here. So we have our miniature phone stand. I don't know. I don't know when I'll use this, because usually I don't really use a phone stand, but this could come in handy, I guess. So, yeah, whichever way you hold it. And then our blue scrunchie. Looks like it. And then a sleeping mask. Wake me for food. I should really put this on cream, because this is what she can relate to. But yeah, and it's all folded in this little suitcase. And then I like how she reused this Betsy Johnson jewelry box. Kind of holographic there. She threw in these random cookie cutters, which actually have the same exact ones as these, except this Christmas tree is pointier than all of mine, but it's good to have extra cookie cutters. I'm all for the tins. Like, the plastic ones just don't really work. You know, you want to have, like, the tins, or, you know, hardcore. Like, I said that I have to say that. But yeah, they just cut out so much better, and they're, you know, the old school, you know, we're used to that. Plus, they're a little easier to clean, because then with the plastic dough, I don't know, for some reason the dough sticks more, and it I don't know, it's hard to clean. And then I have this seemingly notepad, like the sticky book. And then I have this in disguise, looks like a sticky notepad in the match box style. Then you open it, and then it's these miniature emery boards that fly out of here. So it's like, so also for Mary Maxim, it's a snowman shimmery clear lip gloss. I don't want to know how much this was. Apparently it was kind of overpriced. But yeah. You can see the shimmer there. And then I have this peppermint hot cocoa flavored lip balm in its own little cocoa cup container. Let me open this. So it is little labeling. all the little details. It's really cute. I really like that idea, lip balms that look like, pop cans, soda pop cans, or lemonade, the straw, I don't know what it's called, but the flavored lip balm caricatures. And then this lip balm is a little naughty. I think we made it that way, or we really joked about this one. And I had to tell Lee about this because we were wheezing over it. So it's like Santa upside down. It's funny because my aunt thought this was a Reese's cup. But yeah, so he's like this. And then my mom kept saying, well, why do you have to reach in between his legs to pull the lid up? And yeah. And I'm like, I don't know. Apparently it got really interesting over there at Christmas Day opening this. It's like a kind of a generic scented lip balm, actually. It's shimmer to it. It's like I don't want to say strawberry because it smells more like just regular lip balm. But yeah, we just thought it was so funny. And then my last item from Leah is these, what I call breakfast at Tiffany's clubs from Mary Maxim. I think the brand is Cherie Bliss. But yeah, I really, they're not like winter gloves, but they keep you decently warm, and I think they're really more for fashion. But you could see the gemstones and pearls. I should say rhinestones. Rhinestones and pearls on here. And this one also has the same, except it has the silhouette of a cat with its pearl collar, which is coconut. And I just love these. These are great for fashion and being dingbatty. And very frivolous, but practical. So, and then as a bonus, I wanted to showcase these decorative boxes that came from our last holiday Harry and David order. This is the back, but the top cover is really pretty. I love all these ornaments on here. It has like a kind of a vintage 50s-ish design, which I love. And I just like these Christmas trees. Because they have like such a, it's not your traditional, it's very like, it shows like the skeleton of the tree. The bare branches of the tree and then like little pops of white. And the star is cute. I didn't get these for Christmas. This was like something for the family, but I just wanted to showcase those two boxes. So that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed, and I will see you again in the next one.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that my heart and mind embraces